We're back
with a new year, right?
Oh yeah, starting off the new year with
Happy New Year, everyone.
New vlog.
Yes.
All right. So, what are we gonna do for a movie vlog? Well, if they haven't already seen the title, which it's like, I never liked it when people are always like, "Oh, I have a surprise for you," but underneath the YouTube
the title, there.
It's like, "Oh, what's the surprise?" Yeah. So, we're gonna talk about Rogue One.
Yeah.
Oh wait, no, Disney's trademark. Rogue One trademark, a Star Wars story trademark.
Yes.
That we both saw at a different time.
Times, yes.
I went with my friends and you went with your
friend as well, yes.
Yeah, to go see it. And yeah, so we're just here to talk about it. So what's the plot of this movie, D. Tyson?
Well, it seemed like it started off, well, obviously it's a prequel, yes. So it's showing before the episode the 4, right?
Yes.
So before all of that, you see, you know, how the Empire was dealing with, well, they were creating something very dangerous, right? The Death
something
Star.
Something deathly. Yes,
deathly.
Yeah,
yes.
Actually, that, you know, that's not even a spoiler. In the trailer, it was just like,
I think they gave that away, right?
Pretty much. It was just like,
the shadow, yeah.
The shadow of it. Yeah. It's like, and it's not even a spoiler in general, because we all know it's going to be the Death Star. So the story behind this is like, how did they get the Death Star?
Yes.
And we find out, like, who these people are. And that's essentially the plot.
Yeah.
What do you think of about the plot like that?
Well, I mean, it's with, I guess she became,
just the whole premise of just, like, we have these bunch of characters, and they're just here to grab the Star Wars planet just so we can tie together episode 3 and 4 together. Like, what do you think about that, like, quality-wise?
I think it was okay. I mean, I wasn't really sure what kind of story they were gonna do. I thought maybe,
well,
yeah. Like, did you see this coming, or did you expect something
different
from what you saw in the trailer? Anyway,
let's see. When I saw it, it was like, oh hey, they're gonna be like, oh, how they got the Death Star plan. It's like, oh okay, that could be kind of neat, but I hope they make it interesting. What I got from the trailer was like, it was an Empire like employee a soldier of the Empire like defects to be like we gotta stop the super weapon because it's you know, super fucking deadly and yeah. Shit and I was like, oh hey, it's gonna be a betrayal story kind of thing, like you know, work with the Empire for so long and see the terrible shit they're gonna do, and it's like, I'm gonna defect to the rebellion. Speaking of the trailers, the very first of the trailer is a lying pile of shit.
Yeah, so something missing, right?
No, a whole lot of shit is missing. Like, that battle on the beach, no spoilers, where they're getting shot by the AT-ATs. It's like, you see the main characters and the cast, like, running towards it, and they're just, like, shooting at it. That was not in the movie. That was not in the movie. There are just parts that were just not in the movie that they changed because...
Well, initially it was supposed to be much darker, and I think since Disney...
What?
Yeah, since Disney owns the rights, maybe they kind of had to tone it down. But then again, like... Didn't, like Deadpool was also with Disney, right? Because Marvel and... Isn't it?
Would it be?
I think so, technically. Yeah, because...
It's part of Marvel, Disney, and it's not part of Fox.
Yeah, because Disney owns Marvel, right? So
yeah, so...
so I don't know what their excuse is, guys. All I can think of is, you know, Star Wars has a big legacy, and a lot of younger viewers watch it, and maybe they don't want to... You know, they want to offend anybody.
So you will say they wanted to make it safe.
Yeah, they
which,
played safe. Yeah,
which
sure.
is, did you think that was a good move for it to make it to play safe for a series this big? Because
I think it was okay. Like, it still had a dark tone. Like, it wasn't like too dark. It wasn't too, you know, like
it was kind of in the middle where it was just like
it was okay, like
mediocre.
I think so. Like, I had just the right amount. I think it wasn't like too dark, but it was dark in some ways. Not as dark as Empire Strikes Back or anything, but I mean.
Yeah.
That was probably one of the darkest ones.
But it wasn't, like, unwatchable as a kid, or for kids,
no,
I would say. Unless,
no.
You know, your kids have that. Or, like, those kids, it's like, okay, if your kids have trouble watching Empire Strikes Back, then they really suck. It's like, oh, I can't watch it, it's too dark. No, it was such a good reveal and such and all that. But what did you think about, like, the whole movie then? Like, did you like it?
Yeah, I thought it was good. I mean, I didn't go in with too much expectations.
Me neither.
A lot of people were hyping it up and everything. I wouldn't say it's a great movie, but it's good for what it is. I thought it was enjoyable.
Yeah, there was a lot of hype. Like, when we go to Swiss Chalet, there was like a Rogue One price.
Yeah.
It was like, what's this? It's like, buy a Rogue One cup.
Well, they always do that. They're going to merchant, you know, the merchant.
I know, but it was like,
yeah.
I don't see it that often.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was just a whole lot of... I didn't even know there was a Rogue One story. I was just like, I just saw this, like, a trailer that someone was showing. I was just like, ooh, it was like, wait. Oh, it's a Star Wars thing. I wasn't excited for it. It was just like, some friends of mine are like, hey, you want to watch Rogue One? And I'm like,
yeah,
sure. I saw it in 3D IMAX, by the way, which is apparently, if you were watching on YouTube at the time of this video, there's always this ad that was like, oh, the cinema, the IMAX 3D makes the writing, makes the choreography, the look, the narrative so much better, or some shit like that.
Is it true? No, screw you, yes.
Okay. How does an IMAX experience improve the narrative? I think that's already like a... Yeah. That, you gotta raise an eyebrow for that.
It improves, like, supposedly the visual experience, right? But not really the...
I didn't even notice the 3D. The
content, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Unless, you know, the IMAX gave us the dark version of it.
Yeah, true. I saw the regular version, so I did not see the 3D, guys. So I don't know how that's different. But there is also a 4D. I was throwing...
So why don't you tell me about that?
Yeah, so some of my friends apparently saw a 4D version. So basically...
Does Toronto even have 4D?
Yes. I don't know how much it costs, guys, but your seat will move in certain sequences in the film. There's wind blowing at you to simulate that you're actually in the background or whatever. The only thing there's no lasers, like, you know, flashing at you. That'd be kind of cool, like, if there's, like,
wouldn't
shooting.
Wouldn't it be bad for, like, people with seizures and, like, a shot, yeah, like, that's laser probably corners why. That's, in your eye why. Would, like, damage
that's
your
probably
eye?
That's probably why, yeah. I mean, they wouldn't do it directly in your eye, but maybe, like, you know, lower or something, or... But, yeah,
What if it's, like a short kid, yeah, or true, like, midget? It's, like, you shoot into their eyes, it's like...
That's true. Yeah, I guess it wouldn't work.
I guess you'd have to wear those, like...
Unless they shoot, like, above everybody's head.
What if,
like...
some guys are really tall? And so they just shouldn't do that. Or maybe give everyone, like, laser protection glasses. Like, put these on, or yeah, else you might get blinded during this movie. And it's like, wait, why would you advertise a movie like this?
Yeah, so I'm not sure what's the best version of this film. I mean, 4D sounds kind of cool. Would you have wanted to see that if it was at a good price? Possibly.
Yeah, I imagine it would have been like $30, and I would have just been like, just for a movie. Yeah. I could buy three people's tickets for that. And if it was on Tuesday,
Tuesday, $8, yeah.
I probably messed up, and you're all going to be like, no, it's actually $6 or something like that. But like,
no, you're right. It is $8 on Tuesday. Yeah.
$8 on Tuesday, so like between $30. Actually, no, that's four people. And then you add a little more, and then you probably could do like five.
Yeah, but I mean, the way I saw it, I thought it was okay. I mean, usually 3D doesn't really enhance it. Like,
no, I just completely like forgot, like, oh, hey, this movie's in 3D.
Yeah.
Actually, the Spider-Man Homecoming trailer, the 3D was better in there, because when the Vulture was coming in, like...
You can see from above.
Yeah, and he's coming in, he's like, he uses his claws. I actually moved, because I was like, this is too much. My instincts. That was more effective.
Yeah, but Star Wars didn't really have that many sequences that utilized that well, yeah.
They tried to do that thing with, like, Phantom Menace 3D. Hey, you think...
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Did that work out?
Not really. I mean,
wasn't made for it.
Nah, they added some other stuff, I think, but yeah, because I hadn't seen the original version of it, so I didn't know what the differences were. But apparently, they added some stuff.
Speaking of which, do you think they're gonna re-release A New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of Jedi in theaters for like people to watch? Because I don't know if you know, but a lot of people are making joke memes about the next Star movie, where it's like it has George Lucas directing and it stars Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher, and... condolences to
Carrie Fisher. I know.
And then you told me her mom died afterwards. Yeah, I was like, what? That's just sad.
Yeah. It's unfortunate. But yeah, you know, I guess the loss was too much for sure.
Okay, that pretty much just killed the joke. But Rogue One.
Yeah. But you know what? I think they will release the other films again to show people.
Like publicly in theaters.
Yeah, they've done
TV.
It before. I'm sure
that'd be cool. I would actually pay to like watch it.
Yeah, they've done it before. I'm sure they'll do it. But yeah, I don't know what the next film's gonna... Like, which direction it's gonna go into now.
That's kind of tough. That is tough, huh? But anyways, yeah. For me, what I thought about the film... It was okay. You know, I came into it with no expectations either. It was just like... I was invited to watch, and I was like, oh, okay, cool. Let's see what's up. I think the only part I enjoyed about the film was the battle scene at the end on the beach. No spoilers, once again. Because it's in the trailer. And it's... Yeah. Really, this whole movie has, like, no... Like, there's no surprise. It's just, like, everything you saw in the trailer is in that movie. And they're going to win because there's an episode 4 that already exists. So, clearly, there's no tension. There's no, come on, man. Are they going to do it?
Well, I mean, there was that scene where, you know, the rebel Cassian, you know, he's sent to kill.
That's one of the characters.
Was it Galen? Was it
Galen? Jyn Erso. Ursa's father.
Her father, sorry. And yeah, he's got him at gunpoint, but then he can't bring himself to do it. So I guess
even though he's killed many other people, like I don't know. I don't think he grew that much of an attachment to the main character. It's just been like, fuck you. We need to kill this man so that he cannot keep helping the Empire.
Yeah.
Turns out, and then the father dies anyways in that exact same scene, which is really dumb. There are so many dumb moments in it. But anyway, going back to the name, there are so many names in this movie, and it's just like, it's like Donnie Yen's character. Like, I don't remember.
It was like Shiru.
You have to, like, bend and break your own jawbones just to pronounce
his name. And his buddy was a Baz or something.
I didn't even know that was his name. It was just like Donnie Yen's sidekick.
I don't really remember much of the names of this film
other than Jyn Erso,
because they keep saying their name.
And it's not even spelled J-I-N, because I thought it was going to be a thing like Qui-Gon Jinn from Phantom Menace. But no, it's J-Y-N, which works, but it's like it's just weird to me.
Yeah, do you feel like her character was
well-developed?
Yeah, well-developed, or like given as much... I don't know. I thought in the end, can we do spoilers here or no?
We already know pretty much what's happened. It's like if you're just gonna watch the movie, it's just to just watch the movie.
Yeah. So in the part where you know it looks like she's in trouble or she's fighting off that
director
Krennic, I think his name was.
Yeah, the director.
Yeah, so she's fighting off the director, and then you know we thought that Cassian had fallen off.
They were trying to get the Death Star plans. No spoilers. Yeah, yeah. Cassian gets knocked out, and then he at the end.
Yeah, so apparently he somehow you know comes back and makes it
in time to like save her. Which, after like a monologue, it's like, "Who are you? I am the daughter of Galen Ursa, and I'm gonna keep monologuing until my buddy comes and shoots you in the back."
Yeah.
Whoop.
Like I thought. Either she could have, you know, defended herself, or
she
like
she had a pistol,
or the character that they kind of
K25,
K2SO or 5, I forgot.
SO, sorry.
So
by the way, that character is probably the best part of the movie.
Yeah, because they initially they don't get along, and it'd been kind of cool if maybe he saved her in the end.
You had a much better plot.
Yeah, that would have been
for cool. for that cool. where he comes to save her, and we know he got shot and died, but you did bring up the thing where he was like you thought he was hacking the robot, but he was actually downloading. Yeah. I was like. If he actually hacked it to where it's like he copies himself, cool. It comes back. It's like, I thought you were dead.
Yeah.
Well, I'm Cassian told me to keep you safe.
Yeah.
And I did.
Yeah, that would have been cool.
That would have been a nice touching moment, but Cassian just somehow makes it through what I assume is what Jyn also went through, because there was this part where like for some reason there's a hole that's just like clamping in, and I'm like, why is that in there?
That's the suckiest hole ever, isn't it? It's like.
No, like, what's the point in there? It's in the data storage. It's like, it's just there just to be like, oh, look, danger.
So I guess Cassian it's supposed to, like, flush things out, maybe? I don't know.
Wait, in the data room? Why would you throw things into the data room? That thing made no sense.
Yeah, it didn't. Maybe, like, sometimes they get rid of data and then it just opens and everything.
No, that's where they store the stuff.
Yeah, but, like, say they want to get rid of a file.
Why would they throw it upwards and turn, like, something else? That data room was also stupid, too. How the fuck were you supposed to find anything? Like well, the hard drives and stuff. It's like you gotta look at this computer. Well, and
she found it under Stardust because that was her nickname that her father gave her. But
yeah, we're just spoiling shit up the ass and stuff.
It's okay.
Yeah, and
what else bothered you? I know there was another scene that bothered you. Think back if you can remember.
Shit.
One of your favorite characters in this film.
Oh yeah, the death of not my favorite character, but Donnie Yen's character when he died. No surprise. Everyone fucking dies in this movie.
Yeah, so he's blind. You know, he's a badass. He can defend himself well.
And he's in tune with the Force, but he's not quite a Jedi. He's more like a believer.
Yeah, he's a believer. So, yeah, I mean...
He was pretty neat, but Donnie Yen's character was just kind of like... I felt like they just got him in just to be like, we have Donnie Yen in our movie because of the Ip Man movies. Yeah. What did you think about his performance in this movie? Like they'd make you go like, wow, this movie is so much better because Donnie Yen was in it.
I mean, I liked his scenes. I thought it was okay. I thought he should have had more of a heroic death, maybe.
Yeah,
like,
yes, and that's the part that bugged me because at the end when it's like, he had to press this button to like, what was it?
Send the
signal.
The signal, yeah.
Yeah, so he basically walks out. He's like, oh yeah, you'll hear this quote a lot. I am the Force, the Force is me, and that stuff. So he goes through, and, like, everyone misses him because the Force is protecting him. Presses the button, like, does the job, and then he gets fucking punked by, like, a rocket explosion. I was like, all the stuff he survived. Death Star laser, up-close laser fight, that scene just now, punked up by a rocket.
I don't know. And then his buddy also...
Bites the dust.
He goes out fighting, but yeah, he dies pretty much right after.
Yeah, that was just like... I felt like that was just to be like, okay, we need these people to die.
Yeah, and then we have Jin and Cassian, you know, together at the end, and they just get, I guess, basically nuked
by the Death Star. If Donnie Yen's character...
If that happened to him, that'd be
if it was like at the end, it was like they were like all together, like, we did it. We're gonna fucking die, because the Death Star is shooting at us, and... Donnie is at the end. He's like, "I am the Force. The Force is me."
Yeah, I think
that would have been much better. But fuck you, fuck you, writers.
One thing else I didn't like. I know, like, I want to pull the race car or anything. But remember how there is that one soldier who's black, and he's like, "I'll get it," and he dies like right away. Remember? Remember that? Oh, like, come on. Why would they put that in the script? That was bad.
That sounds like a stereotype.
That was bad.
Kind of like in a horror movie. Like, who's the first guy to die?
I was like, come on, give him a chance. Like, honestly, they just killed him right away. He's like, I got it, and then he just gets shot. Like, aren't you upset?
No, come on, man. But what was the point of him? If he's gonna die anyways and not accomplish anything, he might as well have just died before that scene.
Yeah, I mean, come on. I mean, at least the previous... Or not the previous movie, I should say the last, or the seventh movie, I should say, the Star Wars. At least that character, you know, had a
role.
Yeah, he was out throughout the whole movie. But this guy just dies in one shot. It's like, come on, man.
Okay.
I don't know.
It was just to be like, oh my, this scene is suddenly more important. Yeah. Like, why?
Yeah.
It just needs to be pushed. You just need to push a button. That's it. Like, I can do it. Well, maybe not survive through it unless I just believe in the Force.
Yeah.
But there was also so much stuff in the trailer that wasn't there. Like at the scene in the Rebel base, it's like Jin's just said a whole bunch of other stuff. If you look at the trailer and saw the actual movie, you'll know the difference. And at the end, you know the part when she's going to realign the satellite dish. In the trailer, a TIE fighter comes up. In the movie, it's not there. Because I was just like, wait, something's not right. I'm not remembering the trailer right.
Yeah, I think maybe the writers drank some too much gin and before they released the film. I don't know. They changed a lot of stuff. But you know what? Yeah, well, there'll be more movies, I'm sure. There's going to be another kind of prequel of some kind.
There is stuff to bitch about in this movie, but it's not too bad.
Yeah. So what's next? A Han Solo movie?
Shit.
I don't know.
That's
what they were talking about.
That could be a thing. Yeah. Especially with the CG. I didn't expect Grand Moff Tarkin to be in this movie. When I saw him, I was like, for one brief second, I was like, not like that, but in my head, I was like, whoa, that guy is still alive? And it's like, wait, no, he's dead.
But this is a...
It looked really good. Yeah. Apparently most of the budget was spent on just making him look like he's there.
And the weird thing is, some people complained about the CGI. I don't know why.
I didn't fucking notice because you guys are picky.
I mean, even like with the last scene with Princess Leia, they said she looked too like bright or
too
something.
Too plasticky or like puffed up. I can see that, but
okay.
It still looked good. Yeah. It still looked good. It looked way better than some of the older stuff, like where you try to like replicate someone. Like I heard from like the X-Men movie where it's like try to youthen Patrick Stewart's like face as Professor Xavier. Didn't you see the X-Men? Wait, not First Class, right?
Yeah, First Class. Actually, wasn't that a different actor though? I don't know.
Like at the end when he like recruits the. Oh wait, no.
Yeah, it's probably a different movie. But yeah.
Wait, maybe it was X-Men Origins of Wolverine.
Yeah, maybe
something like that.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I didn't think the special effects were bad. I mean,
no, they were pretty good. I got really like the end scene was on the battle on Scarif is like that was like. The part I would like watch again, so that's not saying much for a movie, because a good movie has you watching all the way through. The first half of this movie, I'm just like, you see it once, you're just like, fuck off.
Yeah, a lot of people were excited about Darth Vader's appearance for sure,
which was okay.
He used this famous choke, and he
says, don't
choke on your aspirations.
Okay, would he actually say that in like the original movie?
That
seems too goofy for him. It's like because he was like. Careful, director. You don't want to choke on your ambition. It was just like, what the fuck? I forgot about it until like one of my buddies like brought it up, and I'm like, fuck, yeah, that's right. And then the thing is like, the rebellion is built on hope. That was just that was too fucking cheesy.
No.
Well, lactatingly cheesy.
But the next movie was going to be called A New Hope, so I mean, I guess it kind of ties in, right?
Yeah, but it was like it was like
it's a given.
It was like a bad pun.
Yeah.
Also, another scene that really bugged me, you know, on that rainy planet that I always forget the damn name on? Like, when the X-Wing pilots were coming in to shoot down, like, the base, like, do a bombing run to kill Galen.
Okay.
The director lands there, like, his ship in front of the, like, the landing pad, and, like, the landing pad. The rebels come in, they shoot up everything but his ship. What the fuck was that? The rebels in this movie are so fucking stupid, it irritates me.
Yeah.
There was that part. It was like, you could have killed the director like halfway in the movie if you shot his ship or, you know, prevented him from escaping and whatnot. Something that like that. But no, after like the fire, the little like dogfight, it's like the ship's still there. I'm like, how? If I was in that fucking squadron, the first thing I shoot is the fucking transport ship. So nothing escapes. And then in the space battle at the end, like, even that irritated me a bit. There was a part, like, you know when all the TIE fighters were flying out? I was like, if I was in that fucking squad, or I was commanding, I was like, destroy, like, the loading dock. So it's like, so you don't have TIE fighters flying everywhere. But no, they just left it, like completely open for them to come up and be like, hey, get ready to get fucked! That was stupid. They were, like I said, there's a lot to bitch about in this movie. But it's like, it's not the worst.
No, it's not.
Movie. Speaking of worst, some people said this movie is their favorite, like, out of all the Star Wars movie. Would you say that? I wouldn't.
No, I can't. I can't say that.
A New Hope is always going to be, like, my personal favorite. And including the original, too. Like, a lot of people like Empire Strikes Back, which is also a good movie, but I like A New Hope because it's, like, just, you can watch that movie and just be done with it. That was a good standalone movie.
Yeah.
But Empire Strikes Back and Return of Jedi, you kind of have to watch both to appreciate the whole thing. And
I think for me, I like the Return of the Jedi just because it was the first one that I ever saw. And I like the whole thing with, you know, the father and son, and you know, he actually redeemed himself in the end. So I thought that was nice.
That was a touching scene.
Yes, and the Emperor, obviously. Palpatine, I always thought that actor is really good. He did a really good job with the Revenge of the Sith as well, part 3.
Yeah, same actor, by the way.
Yeah, he did a really good job.
So it was funny. It was like, when he was younger, he played an old guy. Yeah. And then in the prequels, he turned into an old guy to play a young guy to become an old guy.
It's kind of cool. But he's a really good actor. I always enjoyed his performances.
Yeah, he was great. He was very into it.
I can feel your anger.
Let's see. And the other characters, let's see. There's that one Imperial pilot. He pretty much gets bitch killed off as, like, you know, grenade. The only character I really liked was the robot, K2SO, because he was funny. And that was the only thing that was keeping me awake, kind of.
Yeah.
Because there's some pretty good action, but it's just kind of like, whatever.
He's always there. I mean, those characters are always there for, like, support. Like, supporting role characters, I guess. Like, same with C-3PO and R2-D2.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, and then there are the cameos and kind of, like, references and stuff, like C-3PO and R2-D2 were in the
thing. Oh, yeah, and that one's, true.
That one's in that one. How come no one ever tells me anything?
Yeah.
It was like, hey, wait a minute. Why are they on the base? Because remember in The New Hope, they were in the ship, so... Wait, how are they at the Rebel base and not on the ship that had the plans?
I don't know. Maybe plot.
Someone fucked up! Because some people said, like, they threw all this stuff just for fan service.
Yeah.
Hard to deny. But now that I think about it, if C-3PO and R2-D2 were at the Rebel base, and, like, because that was the scene where, I think that was the scene where they're, like, going to the battle. So did he get on the ship afterwards, or was it, like, was he going to get on it, or was he staying at the thing? Because that makes sense now that I think about it. Oh, yeah. I'm glad there's no, like, romance in this movie, because I would just been like, this is just, like, you're playing into that.
That's why I felt like Cassian, you know, didn't have to survive. Like, he could have been, you know, killed, because there was not going to be a romantic, you know, tie between
Not that it was going to last anyways.
No, so.
And, what was it? And there wasn't any lightsaber battle in this movie, except at the end when Vader jacks all the rebels. That was a pretty cool scene. I enjoyed it just because it was badass.
And he just missed getting that was it the code was it or
the data
card. Yeah, data card. We just missed it.
Although that kind of makes him look really much dumber, because it's like his force power should have been like, and then grab the guy, and then it's like.
I guess he was too arrogant, maybe. That also shows like he didn't think.
Your overconfidence is your weakness. Yeah,
pretty much.
And then.
Maybe.
No, it still kind of makes him. It still kind of makes him dumb, though, in a way, because. No, just not really.
Alright.
But yeah, I just like I said, like I just feel like okay with the movie as a whole. Would I watch it again? Just if I did, it would just be the battle on Scarif, because that part was the only like really entertaining part that kept me engaged. Would you watch it again?
No, I think once is enough. I don't really see much more you can get from a second viewing. Maybe I'll find something I missed, but other than that, no, I don't see myself buying the DVD or Blu-ray.
No, I don't think I would buy the thing. No. But would you recommend people watch it?
Yeah, if they're fans of the series, just watch it once.
I think if they're fans of the series, they probably already watched it. As for me, you are not missing anything. If you're like a hardcore fan, I think this movie is just probably going to piss you off, because it's just like, well, it depends. If you're like a light fan, you'll be like, oh, look at all these references. I know who they are because of Star Wars. But if you're like a hardcore fan, you'll be like, how did this happen? No, this is not how it happened. Because there are some video games.
Yeah.
Like this one on the DS where it's like you play as like a character that steals a Death Star plan. So like where did that come in and so forth?
Well, I guess it's like an alternate universe maybe kind of thing. Yeah.
Potentially. Yeah. But I guess it's better that it was like an alternate universe because it's not official. Now that this is official, now it, like, you know, we have... Well, you don't have to accept it, but it's like it's officially accepted into like the timeline thing. But Star Wars Rogue One. Oh yeah. Where does that name come from? When that name comes from in the movie when they were trying to leave for the planet Scarif, and it's like, Bodhi. What call sign are you?
Bodhi says.
Rogue One. End scene. Oh yeah, it didn't have the title crawl in this movie either.
No, it didn't. No, because it. I guess it's a Star Wars story, but it's not like, you know, a full-fledged.
Like it's like a small story in the universe, like not important enough to be in.
Yeah, it's a prequel, but one is
they call it 3.5.
Yeah, so when it's the next sequel, then they'll have the main story coming across and everything. But yeah,
all right, guys. Well, we don't want to force this movie on you. You know, watch it if you want to,
see how you like it. You're not missing anything.
No.
If you don't want to watch it, then that's fine. But if you want to watch it, you're also not really getting much out of it, I would say. So, 3 out of 4, I would say...
Yeah, that's about right.
No, 3 out of 4 decisions, I would say. Yeah. You can probably skip it. But if you really want to watch it, then, you know, that's where the 1 out of 4 comes from. But, yep. May the Force be with you. And the Force is us. And we are the Force.
All right, guys. Have a fantastic... New Year, bounce me back, peace.
Enforce.